Where should you live as an expat in Santo Domingo? On today's video, I'm giving you the top 8 neighborhoods for you to live as an expat in Santo Domingo, in my opinion. But before we get started, if you are new to the channel, welcome. If you like this type of content and also you like Dominican culture, learning Spanish, lifestyle, learning some Dominican cooking, you are in the right place. So don't forget to like this video and let's get started. Most of these places are located in the southwest of Santo Domingo, and I choose these places because I know some of you guys, they want to go and live sometime in the Dominican Republic or trying to spend some time, but want to live in the same comfort that you have in countries like US, Canada, and other developed countries. So those places have the same type of comfort. You don't have to worry about the power going off or the water going off. Those places are already prepared with backup generators and everything that you need. The first one is Los Cacicazgos. This one is considered rich and lavish. This neighborhood is located between the Anacaona Avenue and Mirador Sur. Anacaona Avenue is considered the most expensive price by square footage in the Dominican Republic. The population is 25,000, mainly upper class people. And you can find apartment and houses here anywhere from $1,400 to $7,000. So guys, if you want to live in this area, you need that buy. The second one is Piantini. This area have the second most expensive prices of square footage in the Dominican Republic. The population is about 65,000, and the people that live around this area is upper class. It's located between Kennedy and 27 de Febrero. You can find American restaurant like Taco Bell and also some other Dominican local restaurant. And you can find apartment or houses in this area between $1,000 and $6,000. So guys, this area right here is one of my favorite. Whenever I decide to go back to the Dominican Republic, this is one of the places where I would like my apartment to be. In this area, you can, it's a lot of things close in this area, like in Acropolis Mall, which is a mall, you can find Hooters. They have a La Posta, which is like a bar cafe, which is very nice. So you can find a lot of things in this area. This is a very nice area to live. The third one is Ensanche Naco. The people that live in this area are considered upper middle class. The population is about 25,000. You can find American establishment like Taco Bell and Radisson Hotel. And you can find apartments anywhere from $750 to $3,000. The next one is Bella Vista. Bella Vista is another upper middle class neighborhood. And in this neighborhood is between 27 de Febrero and Anacaona Avenue. You can find American establishment like McDonald's close to it. Also, they have Bella Vista Mall. And you can find apartment between $700 and $3,000 around this area. So guys, Bella Vista is another good area. This is where I have my restaurant when I was living in Dominican Republic in 2015. The only thing that I don't like about Bella Vista is that depending where you are, like for example, if you are more east of Bella Vista, you can find like, you can be across the street for a lower class neighborhood. But if you are more west, you are out of that area. The next one is El Millon. This is another upper middle class neighborhood. The population is about 15,000. And this one is located between Gustavo Mejia Ricard Avenue and 27 de Febrero. You can find in this area American establishment like McDonald's, another Dominican franchise like Adrian Tropical, and you can find apartment and houses in this area anywhere from $500 to $1,500. This area, El Millon, the translation, the million, doesn't cost you $1 million to get in or to stay in. I recommend it. It's also a very nice neighborhood. The next one is Los Prados. This one is another upper middle class neighborhood in Santo Domingo. The population is about 30,000 and it's between Kennedy and 27 de Febrero Avenue. It's located by west of Piantini and north of El Millon. The closest mall is Acropolis, and you can find American establishments like Krispy Kreme and Little Caesar. You can find apartment or houses around $500 and $1,500 in this area. So guys, this is a very safe and economical area to live for those they are looking not to spend a lot of money. The next one is Gazcue. This is another upper middle class neighborhood. However, it was originally considered upper class. It has about 15,000 people and is a lot of government offices in this area. This area is located in the George Washington Avenue, which is the Malecon area, and this is located next to the Zona Colonial, where you can find many things like hotels, casinos, restaurants, and bars. You can find an apartment in this area anywhere from $400 to $1,500. I like this area because it's affordable and also it's next to the Zona Colonial, which is, if it's your first time visiting the country, you have a lot of historical places to go. Okay, and the last one is Zona Colonial. And I'm sure if you have been in Santo Domingo or it's your first time going, you have heard about Zona Colonial. This is the most tourist destination in Santo Domingo. And this is where a lot of tourists go to visit and stay in this area. This place is located between the Maya Avenue. And you can find an apartment here anywhere between $500 and $1,200. And it's many activities and things to do in this area. It's a lot of bars, historical places. You have the tourist quarries in that area and restaurants, supermarkets, banks. It's a lot of things to do in this area. I really recommend this area if it is your first time in the country, you are trying to stay around all the tourists and around tourist activities. So guys, these are my top 8 neighborhoods that I recommend for you to live as an expat in Santo Domingo. So if you have any questions, feel free to email me or leave a comment down below. However, for those that have a smaller budget and looking for the typical Dominican experience, I'm gonna make another video and I will let you know those are neighborhoods. So if you like this video, give it a big thumbs up. Don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe, and I will see you in my next video. Bye.